corruption at peak. So much so corruption that even Janmabhoomi committees, anything you want there, you had discrimination left, right and center, rule over the villages. You had everybody at the village level also asking money. And relationships with central government and neighboring states were at an abysmal low. That was the time when we took over the reins of the state. And starting then, to the situation that we are in, we've traveled a great distance, and with great pride, I would say that, with great pride. And expecting your cooperation in the days to come, as you had delivered till date, I take this opportunity to thank you and also seek your cooperation going forward. Thanks a lot. Nadu Nedu in education and health sectors, the biggest among all the house sites. One were to conceive 30.62, 30.92 lakh house sites, which probably in the history of Andhra Pradesh or probably history of this country, I doubt in a given 5-year stretch any state would have attempted to give. That many house sites have actually been given, and a new definition to housing concept has come up, wherein today Andhra Pradesh state is the only state probably right there in a good enough position to tap the central government funds on PMAY, because we have the site, we have the house sites strategically in place. So everything that we spoke about, they were never before. Everything is a revolution. Starting from a situation where to conceive such thoughts itself was something big, something because we've never seen it before. Starting from there to actually see a situation where 20 months have passed and we have realized these dreams. That is what makes this government stand apart. That is what makes my officers stand apart. The concept of governance, when transformation has taken place. Earlier, the governance was still the mandal level. Now, the first time we've taken a leap forward and ensured that the governance is now taken to the village level. So this is where the transformation has taken place. So because the governance has shifted out from the mandal level to the village level, in fact, why is it that we shifted this, why did this transformation take place? No, mandal level department was getting corrupt. For everything going to mandal level, it was leading to an inordinate degree of delay, as well as the setup being corrupt. This village level, because you're dealing with the same villagers, 700 houses probably, you're talking about an officer sitting there, it gets difficult for officers to ask money. It gets difficult for officers to ask bribe because you're dealing with the same number of people sitting down there. So now that we've taken this leap and taken it forward to the village level, it's very important that we own this setup. Until and unless every secretary, every HOD who's sitting down here, until and unless you people start to own this setup, it gets difficult for coordination. Because whatever request is posted at the village level, that request should be converted into actionables. And if that request is not converted into actionables, then the confidence on the government is lost, the confidence on the secretary level posting is lost. So we need to make sure that a proper setup is fully in place where a request is seen by the secretary and the HOD also, so that you are monitoring it, so that the collectors and the joint collectors take actionables, so that it is implemented. So that kind of governance, that kind of involvement by the secretaries and HODs is so very important. Last 20 months, it gives me great pleasure having worked with you. In fact, there's one saying, if you're in cricket, captain alone doesn't win the match. It's the entire team effort which put together would ensure victory. And I'm very thankful to God for having given me this team, I'd say that. In fact, because everybody were exemplary, I mean, there's no second opinion about it. And the kind of passion each of you put in, that has caused these revolutionary changes to be brought about. In fact, if we were to look back and see what kind of revolutionary changes have been brought about, in fact, starting from Disha Act, a revolutionary bill giving protection to women and child. Starting from there, especially to women, starting from there to the concept of village secretariats and village volunteer system. And it just doesn't end there. The list goes on to as much as giving detail, going into the details of how to reduce power costs. In fact, today, we are even appreciated by the central government in having taken steps and going into the minute details of how to procure power. In fact, how the power is to be procured also has been changed. And not only in our state, but the whole country is seeing how it has been done. It just doesn't end there as well. Judicial preview, the way how the tenders have been floated to remove corruption, starting from judicial preview to reverse tendering, which has actually ensured that a new paradigm in the area of governance takes place. Introduction of English medium in schools, Raitu Bharosa Kendras in villages, YSR village clinics in the villages, starting from Grama Sachivalayas also in these villages, resurvey of land, which was never done before for the past 100 years. And above all, direct benefit transfers. With a click of a button, without giving any scope for corruption, we could transfer almost 90,000 crores of rupees directly into the hands of the beneficiaries. The best part is, without giving in for corruption, without discrimination.